Dalesway, United Kingdom. I'm Douglas Grigar. I'm the one that does the classes here, both the 3-day and the 1-day seminars. We're going to talk now about coating using the shine or glisten method. Should be connected to the article that explains this in depth, but we're going to actually demonstrate that method here using a standard scoop coater. We're going to place the screen into a screen holding device for coating screens. You can use a commercially available device like this one, or you can make one for yourself. In any case, what we're going to talk about is coating a screen two-handed using the glisten or shine method. We're always going to start with the product side of the screen, or the face side of the screen. So we're going to coat this until the opposite side takes a shine as this emulsion goes through the mesh and into the other side. This is a 120 per centimeter or 305 mesh screens. It's a fairly high mesh. So what we're going to do is start our coating procedure just like normal. We're going to come up, tilt back, pause, allow the emulsion to go back into the scoop coater. As it slides back in, we'll come up that last little bit and pull away from the screen. We're going to continue to do this until the squeegee side, or the back of the screen, takes a shine that looks similar to, say, jelly on toast. We want to make sure that we have all of the emulsion coming through to the other side. We are unconcerned with counting how many scoop coats we put. We're only concerned about getting it through the mesh and making it shine on the other side. We will count once we do that, once we get all of the emulsion through and we know we don't have any trapped air bubbles. Allow the emulsion to go back into the trough, scrape the last little bit up, and I'm going to go one more time. Hopefully, we now have a shine or glisten on the back side of the screen. It tells us we've pushed all of the air bubbles out and the emulsion has come through and kind of folded over the mesh on the other side, giving us this shiny side. Once we have a shine, we're going to turn it around and coat this side with however many coats we need to get the emulsion over mesh rating that we're looking for. A good thick coating so that we can actually resolve our dots and our edge resolution in detail. In this case, I'm using a dual cure emulsion, and we found that in this particular case with this mesh and this emulsion, we would prefer to have approximately 2 or 3 scoop coats of emulsion. In this case, we're going to do 2 coats. And one more. So this pushes all of the emulsion through onto the other side, and this gives us our thickness. Off now to dry, well side back up to the top, squeegee side up, and face side or product side down.